preparation of glucose is from starch. So the first method of preparation of glucose is from sugar or cane sugar. Cane sugar formula?
C12H24O11.
So C12H24O11. This, in presence of water and in an acidic medium, gives us one is glucose, the other is fructose. We also know that the simplest unit of any carbohydrate is glucose or fructose for that matter, both are having the same molecular form. So, the second method for preparation of glucose can be prepared by the hydrolysis of starch. This is the commercial method for preparation of glucose hydrolysis of starch. Formula for starch. Products to the hydroxylamine, it forms glucose oxide, and with hydrogen cyanide, it forms cyanohydrin. So glucose reacts with hydroxylamine, it forms glucose oxide. So what is happening over here? We have NH2OH, it is getting attached to this carbonyl group over here, our molecule of water, H2, and O is removed, CH, double bond, NOH. So CH, double bond, CH, double bond, NOH, this is glucose oxide. So formation of glucose oxide and formation of hydrogen, this reaction with hydrogen cyanide, it forms cyanohydrin. What will both of them indicate? Presence of carbonyl group in glucose. Both these reactions show that glucose has got a carbonyl group present in it. So, second reaction is with hydrogen cyanide, it is forming glucose cyanohydrin. Formation of glucose cyanohydrin, formation of glucose oxide, both indicates the presence of carbonyl group in glucose. So next is, how do we test the formation of, whether the carbonyl group is in the presence of, in the form of a ketone or in the form of a aldehyde. So the next reaction is, glucose is treated with a mild oxidizing agent like bromine water. It can be treated with bromine water, it can be treated with chlorine reagent, it can also be treated with which other tests you have done for aldehyde swelling. So, glucose on treatment with bromine water, the mild oxidizing agent, it will form gluconic acid. So, at carbon 1, it will form carboxylic acid group. This formation of gluconic acid, the formation of gluconic acid confirms that the carbonyl group that is present in glucose is in the form of an aldehyde. Now, you have done the test for aldehyde. Please give me at least maybe one or two tests which confirm the presence of an aldehyde. Bromine water is a test for unsaturation. It also tells us that glucose carbonyl group is present in the form of an aldehyde. The same test to test, basically bromine water is a test for unsaturation. The same reaction, glucose is treated either with Lennox solution or with chlorine solution. Both it will give the preparation of formation of an aldehyde. So what is formed in case glucose reacts with Lennox solution? What is the product formed? We get an orange precipitate. That is orange. What is it of? What is happening here? Reduction is taking place. Reducing nature, what is formed? Cu2O. What happens when glucose is treated with Tollens reagent? Aldehyde, any aldehyde. Any aldehyde is treated with Tollens reagent. What is the observation? Observation of silver mineral. Both are confirmatory tests for glucose. Either we take a sample of an aldehyde, or we take a sample of glucose. So glucose also has an aldehyde in it. That is proved by these reactions that the presence of a carbonyl group in glucose is in the form of a aldehyde. Is confirmed by the formation of gluconic acid when glucose reacts with bromine water. Next reaction we have, when glucose is treated with acetic anhydride. Glucose is treated with acetic anhydride. What happens when glucose is treated with acetic anhydride? A pentaacetyl convey this formation of a pentaacetyl derivative shows that there are 5 OH groups present in glucose. There are 5 OH groups present in glucose.
Hydroxylamide.
components can go both if there is prolonged thinking of two both in presence of HI. What is formed? When glucose is heated with HI, N-hexane, what is the formation of N-hexane? Good syrup. N-hexane indicate. It's a linear chain of six carbon atoms. What is the current reagent H used for? Presence of aldehyde. Which test in glucose suggests that aldehyde group is present in glucose? Bromine water test. In the bromine water test, what is formed?
Thank you.
capable of forming an hemiacetal. Hemiacetals are formed either intramolecular or intermolecular. So, glucose was found to form a intramolecular hemiacetal structure. On forming the intramolecular hemiacetal structure, it was then found that glucose could form a cyclic structure, which proved to be the final structure.